Hey, so this is a really unprofessional video. I don't have a script for this. I just wanted to show you how I made my isolation remix as a celebration of it reaching 20,000 views, and also because, like, a bunch of people kept on asking how I made it. What do I mean a bunch? It was like two people. Whatever. Some people asked how I made it, and I decided I'd show off the project file. Just go through it. I'll probably cut this down in post. So, yeah, that's what we're gonna do. So to start things off, we have the pads. It's just a simple little thing I made in a serum. Nothing groundbreaking. It's just two sine waves with some attack and a filter on it, and hyper applied to it. Now we have the piano. So the piano is hold on. Yeah, it's this piano right here. Piano in 162. I don't remember where I got it from. All I know is that it's like kind of my main piano whenever I need to make a piano in a project. And it served me really well. So this is what it is here. Very simple, very easy. However, I thought I don't know why it meant. Maybe I just thought the intro felt a little bit too thin or something. I don't know, maybe I just wanted to spice it up. But I also added these violins, which are from the Toho sound font. So yeah, it's just some violins. I think yeah, I added these a little bit late into development of the song. Well, late-ish. I don't really remember much of the song, much of the development really. And then we get into the main part of the song. Well, the intro, the main part of the intro, where I'm not good with words. The build-up. So first things first, we've got the saw, the little synth that plays throughout pretty much the entire song. Very easy. It's just a saw with some unison, a little bit of a filter, not even any effects. And then the bass didn't really come through in the mix as much as I wanted it to. So it ends up getting drowned out a lot of the time. It's just a saw wave with some sine to help amplify the sound a bit as like a little sub bass. And it sounds like this. Easy stuff. And then the drums, I have a bad habit where I use FPC to make my drums instead of making them all separate. It's something that's carried over from my earlier days. I'm trying to fix that. So it means I can't just like alter individual parts of the drum, like the kick and the snare, with effects like EQ and whatever. As for the drums themselves, they sound like this. pretty simple stuff. The impact, this impact here came from a Cymatics Odyssey. Along with this white noise, which occurs near the end of the song, so we'll get to that later. And this, FLS Crash 01A, it's a crash cymbal, but I put it in reverse. I learned this technique from Toby Fox. He uses this crash cymbal a lot, and then he'll reverse it. I think it's in, like, Hopes and Dreams. He uses it in a lot of songs. Anyways. Next up, we have the main part of the song, you know, the do, 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 do. That was off key. So for this, it's just a simple synth, once again with Serum. Two saw waves, one of them is an octave lower, both with three in unison, five in detune, a little bit of hyper attached, and it sounds like this. Simple stuff. And all this is just the same from the build-up. Except for the drum beat. Which, I mean, I don't really have much to say. It's just, you know, a drum beat. Simple, simple stuff. Oh yeah, I should also probably explain. So, the kick is from Cymatics Odyssey. The snare is from... Let me see if I can find it here. Yeah, Prime Loops Viper Official Drum and Bass Volume 1. At least I think so, right? Yeah, here it is. The clap is from Cymatics Odyssey. Same with the hi-hat. And the ride. And the crash. So yeah, that's how it is. Then the next part, the that melody, I'm very literate, you know. This is the first synth to not be made with Serum. It was made with 3X Oscillator, a free little it just comes bundled with FL Studio. Next part, it's just the piano again. However, here we get the first introduction to the staccato strings, which I got from the Free Orchestra by Project Sam. Not in relation to me. Yeah, they're just the staccato strings patch. Whoops. There we go. And then the drum beat. Here's where this little piano flourish that happens at the end of like each few measures. This little It's just a little piano flourish. Nothing crazy. I mean, here are the notes if you want them, I guess. Then it's the same up until this part where we get introduced to one of my favorite little pattern names that I have. The I'm very professional. And this part is, it was made with serum. It was made with two square waves, one of them an octave higher. That's it. It's literally just two square waves. What do you want me to tell you? Dang it. Yeah, I mean, not really much else to say there. Then this next bit here was also made with serum. Another few square waves, except this time they're at... God, what do you... What percentage is this again? It's like... I've worked with a... I think it's like a 12% square wave. I know this because I used to work in Famitracker to make songs. Simple stuff. And then you get the first lead synth coming back again with the background sounds. And alongside that, you get some orchestra hits. And all together. Suppose I should tell you about how I mixed this whole thing while I'm here. I don't really have that sophisticated of mixing abilities. It usually just comes down to if I need like it to cover a lot of space, I slap some delay and reverb on it. If I need it to stand out, put some sound goodizer and some EQ, maybe a compressor. The drums are very basic, only a sound goodizer and compressor. Once again, they're all stuck on the same track, so I can't edit each part of it individually. Each sound individually, so I kind of need to like make mixing decisions that account for the broad range of sounds in the drums. I've been trying to get better at it. I do it here and there. But yeah, it's just whatever. Yeah, most of my mixing just boils down to this. Once again, I'm not a professional. Then it's the same, including the little da-da-da-da-da-da-da. And then you get to the key change. And all of these down here, they control the tuning. Because, for those who don't know, in the Limbo song, in isolation, when the key change happens, it actually adjusts the fine tuning by 50 cents. Which means it's actually in between two conventional notes. Here, let me see if I can provide an example. So, Here's the main melody from after the key change. And then, if I disable this... Hold on. I think I just have to do it from here. You hear the difference? Now if I turn it back on... is this the one for the lead? Whatever, you probably heard the difference. Unless you're tone deaf, in which case... rip bozo. Okay, so I actually made a creative choice here. I decided to take the piano from the intro. Key change a moment or And I decided to, you know, do the thing, tune it by 50 cents up, and transpose it up to, well, I mean, it says, it's like in between F minor and F sharp minor, so. I did this because I wanted to give this part of the song more finality as it called back to the original intro to the song. This part. So, I am the name of the synth. Whoa. So, as you can see here, it kind of just—it's just a bunch of random notes until it gets to this part, where it's just like I have such a way with words. this is because I was using. A video of a piano cover of the song to help transcribe it over to FL Studio, because I am awful at transcribing things myself. And it just kept on doing a bunch of random notes, but then I realized that I can just do this instead of having to individually transcribe each note, and it still sounds similar enough to isolation that I can get away with it. Anyways, the synth itself, it's just a sine wave, detuned by 50 cents for the end of the song, with a unison of 5, no effects. However, it also has an LFO on it, attached to the filter and resonance. Which, essentially, what this does is that over time, the filter in the resonance will shift from low to high and back to low. So, here. If I turn the filter off... And then when I turn it back on... Oh yeah, how's the bass doing? Let's check in on the bass. How you doing, bass? It's doing fine. love this white noise that happens here, because if you listen to it, it kind of goes back and forth between the left and right side of your headphones, which I think is really neat because it mimics this part of the level where the ball is going up and down in the corridor. I think that's really neat. I didn't mean it for it to be like that. It's just kind of happy little accident. Anyways, then you get to the end of the song. And look, I know this is corny, but the fucking choir, it just makes it so final, you know? Like, this is it. You're about to beat Limbo or some shit, I don't know. The choir, it comes from this little VST, which I think is free. I think you can find it on, plugins for free. Which, believe it or not, is not a malware site. But yeah, it's called Microtron, and I just adjusted the choir patch on it. Easy peasy. Here's how it looks inside the piano roll. As it is aptly stated by this pattern, the finale. And they're just another instance of staccato strings from the Free Orchestra plugin. But this time, they're, hold on, what number is it again? Yeah, 14. This time, they're mixed a little bit differently from the other staccato strings. Even though they use the exact same plugins for mixing. Look, they're a little bit different, okay? And all of it culminates in this final part. And then I added these final piano chords to represent. I just added these on a whim, but then I realized, wait, there's three chords here. That just like, you know, three numbers in the number 300, which is the amount of subscribers I made this as a special for. And, yeah, that's pretty much it. That's all I have to show you. Thanks for putting up with your patience for me on my, video essay. These, past few months have been absolutely horrible. But, hey, I'm still breathing, so I don't know. Whatever. We're done here. We're done here. Have a good day. Yeah, good day. I'm recording this at 9 in the morning. All right, see ya.